so you don't miss any of our videos. For African leaders who boldly stood up to unending imperialist tendencies of the former colonial powers, this has generally been met with death. Some of these presidents could be directly or indirectly responsible for their deaths, while others were simply killed because they loved and fought for their people against all odds. So, in no particular order, these are 20 African presidents who were assassinated either in office or after they left office. Number 1. Ibrahim Barre Mainazara, 1999, President of Niger. General Ibrahim Barre Mainazara was a military authority and diplomat in Niger who ruled the country until his assassination during the military coup of April 1999. He became the 5th president of Niger, January 1996, and was the president for over 3 years. On April 9, 1999, Mainazara was ambushed and shot to death by soldiers, reportedly members of the Presidential Guard, at the airport in the capital city of Niamey as he was going to board a helicopter attempting to flee the country. The circumstances of the killing were not really clear. Rumors suggested that Mainazara was attempting to flee the country. Initially, his death was officially described as an unfortunate accident, but this claim was widely considered implausible. Coup leader Dauda Malam Wanki succeeded him as head of state and initiated a political transition that ended with elections late in the year. Number 2. Gregoire Kayibanda, 1977, President of Rwanda. Gregoire Kayibanda was the first elected president of Rwanda. As pioneer of the Rwandese revolution, he led Rwanda's struggle for independence from Belgium and replaced the Tutsi monarchy with a republican form of government. On July 5, 1973, Defense Minister Major General Juvenal Habyarimana overthrew Kayibanda in a military coup. Although described as bloodless, as a result of the coup, an estimated 55 people, mostly officials, lawyers or businessmen close to the previous regime, were reportedly executed. The families of these people were given sums of money to pay for their silence. The new government held Kayibanda and his wife in a secret location, rumored to be a house near Kalibiagi, where they were reportedly starved to death. Number 3. Laurent Kabila, 2001, President of DRC. Laurent Désiré Kabila was a Congolese revolutionary and politician who served as the third president of the Democratic Republic of the Congo from May 17, 1997 when he overthrew Mobutu Sese Seko until his assassination on January 16, 2001. He was succeeded 8 days later by his 29-year-old son, Joseph. By 1998, Kabila's former allies in Uganda and Rwanda had turned against him and backed a new rebellion of the Rally for Congolese Democracy, RCD, the Second Congo War. Kabila found new allies in Angola, Namibia and Zimbabwe and managed to hold on in the south and west of the country. And by July 1999, peace talks led to the withdrawal of most foreign forces. Kabila was shot and killed in his office on 16 January 2001. Number 4. Juvenal Habyarimana, 1994. President of Rwanda. Juvenal Habyarimana was the second president of Rwanda from 1973 until 1994. He was nicknamed Kinani, a Kinyarwanda word meaning invincible. Habyarimana was a dictator, and electoral fraud was suspected of his unopposed re-elections. 98.99% of the vote on 24 December 1978, 99.97% of the vote on 19 December 1983, and 99.98% of the vote on 19 December 1988. During his rule, Rwanda became a totalitarian order in which his MRND party and forces required people to chant and dance in adulation of the president at mass pageants of political animation. While the country as a whole had become slightly less impoverished during Habyarimana's tenure, the great majority of Rwandans remained in circumstances of extreme poverty. On the 6th of April 1994, he was killed when his aircraft, also carrying the president of neighboring Burundi, Cyprien Ntaryamaya, was shot down near Kigali, Rwanda. His assassination ignited ethnic tensions in the region and helped spark the Rwandan genocide. Number 5. Teferi Bante, 1977, President of Ethiopia. Brigadier General Teferi Bante was the head of the state of Ethiopia, 28 November 1974 to 3rd February 1977. He was an Ethiopian politician who served as chairman of the Derg, the ruling military junta. His official title was chairman of the Provisional Military Administrative Council. During his tenure, Teferi presented himself as the public face of the ruling junta. According to the Otterways, while at first he was a natural and powerless figure, in the end he was too colorless, soft-spoken and under-demonstrative to be the figurehead of the revolution. During a routine meeting on 3rd February 1977, Teferi Bente and other Derg members suspected of conspiring with the EPRP were arrested by soldiers under the command of Lieutenant Colonel Daniel. According to the memoirs of Fikir Selassie Wongores, they were then led into a dark garage located in the compound and locked up. Fikre Selassie was also present at the meeting and was mistakenly arrested along with Tafari and the other suspect Dutch members. However, Lieutenant Colonel Daniel Asfaw arrived at the garage in time and released Fikre Selassie before the summary execution of the orders. Shortly thereafter, soldiers armed with automatic weapons and silencers arrived and assassinated Tafari Benti and the suspect Dutch members. Number 6. Muammar Gaddafi, 2011, President of Libya. Muammar Mohamed Abu Minya al-Gaddafi, commonly known as Colonel Gaddafi, was a Libyan revolutionary, politician and political theorist. He governed Libya as a revolutionary chairman of the Libyan Arab Republic from 1969 to 1977, and then as a brotherly leader of the Great Socialist People's Libyan Arab Jamarihiya from 1977 to 2011. He was initially ideologically committed to Arab nationalism and Arab socialism, but later ruled according to his own third international theory. Gaddafi was a Pan-Africanist who fought for the unity of Africa and as such was greatly hated by most Western leaders. Unfortunately, his journey and mission was cut short when he was brutally assassinated to the celebration of Western leaders in 2011. Number 7. William R. Tolbert Jr., 1980, President of Liberia. William Richard Tolbert Jr. was the 20th President of Liberia from 1971 until 1980 when he was killed in a coup d'etat led by Samuel Doe. Trained as a civil servant, he entered the country's House of Representatives in 1943 for the True Whig Party, the then only established party in the country. He was elected Vice President to William Tubman in 1952 and served in that position until he became President following Tubman's death in 1971. Undisputedly, Tolbert was dead by the end of April 12, 1980, the day of the coup d'etat. There are competing stories as to the time and manner of his death. Stephen Ellis, in his book Mask of Anarchy, says the president was found sleeping in his office where the soldiers killed him, while Ellen Johnson's serial biography, This Child Will Be Great, says Tolbert was seized and killed in his bed. Number 8. Samuel Doe, 1990, President of Liberia. Samuel Kamion Doe was a Liberian politician who served as the Liberian leader from 1980 to 1990, first as a military leader and later as a civilian. While a master sergeant in the armed forces of Liberia, Doe staged a violent coup d'etat in April 1980 that left him de facto head of state. During the coup, the then president William Tolbert and much of the True Wing party leadership were executed. Doe then established the People's Redemption Council, assuming the rank of general. Charles Taylor, a former ally of Doe, crossed into Liberia from Ivory Coast on December 24, 1989 to wage a guerrilla war against Doe. Taylor had broken out of jail in the United States, where he was awaiting extradition to Liberia on charges of embezzlement. The conflict quickly flared into full-fledged civil war. By mid-1990, most of Liberia was controlled by rebel factions. Doe was captured in Monrovia in September 9, 1990 by Prince Y. Johnson, leader of INPFL, a breakaway faction of Taylor's NPFL. General Quio, the head of ECOMOG, had invited Doe to the ECOMOG headquarters for a meeting and assured him of his safety from the rebels. On the morning of September 9, 1990, Doe arrived at a precarious time during an ongoing change in guard duty from the well-armed and better-equipped Nigerian team of peacekeepers to the weaker Gambian contingent. The Nigerian team had just withdrawn from the scene when Doe's convoy of lightly armed personnel arrived, none of whom were anticipating any trouble. Doe was escorted to General Quino's office where he was formally welcomed, while most of his team of aides and guards awaited outside. Johnson's rebels surprised everyone by suddenly arriving at the scene uninvited and heavily armed, overwhelming and disarming the entire of Doe's team while encountering no resistance. They then started shooting Doe's team individually and later in groups. Upon hearing the gunshots from outside, Doe expressed concern to Quino, who assured him that all was fine. Quino later excused himself to check on what was happening outside and was followed by his aide, Captain Coker of the Gambian contingent. Both men took cover upon assessing the situation. Johnson's men moved indoors, finished off Doe's remaining team, shot him in the leg and took him captive. When the dust settled, over 80 of Doe's men lay dead. Coker characterized the incident not as a fight but a brutal massacre. Remarkably, none of the ECOMOG personnel were shot in the carnage. Doe was taken to Johnson's military base. To prove that he was not protected by black magic, Johnson ordered that his ears be cut off in Johnson's presence, and he chewed one of them. Then some of Doe's fingers and toes were cut off also. After 12 hours of torture at Johnson's hands, Doe was finally murdered. His corpse was exhibited naked in the streets of Monrovia, where they spilled dirty water on his head. Number 9. Robert Guei, 2002, President of Cote d'Ivoire. Robert Guei was a military ruler and third president of Ivory Coast from December 24, 1999 to October 26, 2000. He was a career soldier. Under the French administration, he was trained at the Ouagadougou Military School and the Saint-Cyr Military School in France. He was an ardent supporter of long-time President Félix Houphouët-Boigny, who in 1990 appointed him chief of the army following a mutiny. After the death of Houphouët-Boigny in 1993, Gueye became distant from the new leader, Henri Konan Bédier. Gueye's refusal to mobilize his troops to resolve a political struggle between Bédier and the opposition leader Alassane Ouattara in October 1995 led to his dismissal. He was made a minister but sacked again in August 1996 and forced out of the army in January 1997. Gueye stood in the October 2000 presidential election as an independent. He only allowed one opposition candidate, Laurent Gbagbo of the Ivorian Popular Front, to run against him. Gueye was soundly defeated by Gbagbo but refused to recognize the result. It took a spate of street protests to bring Gbagbo to power. Gueye fled to Gueseso near the Liberian border but remained a figure in the political scene. He was included in the Reconciliation Forum in 2001 and agreed to refrain from undemocratic methods. Gueye withdrew from the forum agreement in September 2002 but was killed along with his wife, former First Lady Rose Dudu Gueye, and their children on September 19, 2002 in the Kokodi district of Abidjan at the first hours of the Civil War. Number 10. Patrice Lumumba, 1961. Prime Minister of DRC. Patrice Emery Lumumba was a Congolese politician and independence leader who served as the first Prime Minister of the Independent Democratic Republic of the Congo, then the Republic of the Congo, from June until September 1960. Patrice Lumumba was a radical leader of the Congolese independence movement who resisted Belgian colonialism and corporate interests. Lumumba was seized, tortured, and executed in a coup supported by the Belgian authorities, the United States, and the United Nations. With Lumumba's assassination, died a part of the dream of a united, democratic, and ethnically pluralist and pan-Africanist Congo. Number 11. Marien Ngouabi, President of the Republic of Congo. Marien Ngouabi was the third President of the Republic of the Congo from January 1, 1969 to March 18, 1977. President Ngouabi changed the country's name to the People's Republic of the Congo, declaring it to be Africa's first Marxist-Leninist state, and founded the Congolese Workers' Party, Parti Congolais du Travail, PCT, as the country's sole legal political party. Ngouabi was a Koyo from the north and his regime shifted control of the country away from the south. Such moves created opposition among the population and the highly politicized environment of Brazzaville. Bureaucratic centralism, repression, and the mechanism of the party apparatus, the Ngouabi's tribalist orientation towards Mboshi and La Cuvette immigrants created opposition within the Communist Party itself, especially its youth organization. On March 18, 1977, at 14:30 hours, President Ngouabi was assassinated. Those accused of taking part in the assassination were tried and some were executed, including Mazamba Deba. In the aftermath of the assassination, the military committee of the party, CMP, was named to head an interim government with the conservative Colonel Joachim Yombi Opango to serve as head of state. Number 12. Ali Soli, 1978, President of Comoros. Ali Soli, full name Ali Soli, was a Comorian socialist revolutionary and political figure who served as the third president of the Comoros. In 1970, Ali Soli entered politics as a supporter of Zaid Ibrahim, leader of the Democratic Assembly of the Comorian People, Rassemblement Démocratique du Peuple Comorien. He soon developed an ideology of hostility towards France and the former colonial power. His ideas were socialist and he renounced his Islamic faith and became an atheist. On August 3, 1975, less than a month after Comoros gained independence from France, Soli overthrew President Said Mohamed Jafar and became head of Revolutionary Council that took over Comoros. Soli, whose adherents were barely armed, hired French mercenary Bob Bernard to overthrow armed Abdallah. He officially became president of the Revolutionary Council in January 1976. He acquired extensive powers under the terms of a new constitution and implemented socialist economic policies. In 1977, he held a referendum of his presidency, with 56.63% of voters endorsing it. On May 13, 1978, Soli was finally overthrown by a 50-member mercenary unit, largely former French paratroopers hired by exiled former leader Ahmed Abdallah and led by French Colonel Bob Denard. On May 29th, Soli was shot and killed. According to the government, he had attempted to escape from house arrest. Number 13. Ahmed Abdallah, 1989, President of Comoros. Ahmed Abdallah Abderrahmane was a Comorian politician. He was a member of the French Senate from 1959 to 1973 and President of the Comoros from 25th October 1978 until his death. On the 25th of October, Abdallah assumed the title of president and remained in office until his death, despite three separate coup attempts against him. In 1982, Abdallah had the UDC and all the other parties abolished, and a new party, the Comorian Union for Progress, UCP, was set up. The Comoros became a one-party state, with the UCP being the only legal party. The regime became dictatorial, supervised by mercenaries who controlled the country and avoided various coup attempts. Some opponents of the regime were executed and disappeared during this period. The only candidate to be allowed to stand for election, Ahmed Abdallah, was re-elected on September 30, 1984, and his party won all seats in the Federal Assembly on May 22, 1987. During this time, Denard proceeded to plunder the Comorian economy as he became the largest single landowner in the Comoros, taking all over the best land, which he then developed into luxurious hotel resorts for wealthy Western tourists who wished to enjoy the tropics. On the 26th of November 1989, he was shot dead in his Moroni office under a highly disputed circumstance. It is generally believed that Denard had Abdallah assassinated for trying to dismiss him as commander of the presidential guard. Number 14, Francois Tombalbaye, President of Chad, 1975. Francois Tombalbaye was a Chaldean teacher and a trade union activist who served as the first president of Chad. The head of Chad's colonial government and his ruling party, the Chadian Progressive Party, after 1959, Tombalbaye was appointed the nation's head of government after its independence on August 11, 1960. He ruled as a dictator until his deposition and assassination by members of the Chadian military in 1975. Number 15, Melchior Ndadaye, 1993, President of Burundi. Melchior Ndadaye was a Burundian intellectual and politician. He was the first democratically elected and first Hutu president of Burundi after winning the landmark 1993 election. Though he moved to attempt to smooth the country's bitter ethnic divide, his reforms antagonized soldiers in the Tutsi-dominated army, and he was assassinated amidst a failed military coup in October 1993, after only 3 months in office. His assassination sparked an array of brutal tit-for-tat massacres between the Tutsi and Hutu ethnic groups, and ultimately sparked the decade-long Burundi civil war. Number 16, Sylvanus Olympio, 1963, President of Togo. Sylvanus Epifanio Olympio was a Togolese politician who served as Prime Minister and then President of Togo from 1958 until his assassination in 1963. He came from the important Olympio family, which included his uncle Octaviano Olympio, one of the richest people in Togo in the early 1900s. After graduating from the London School of Economics, he worked for Unilever and became the general manager of the African operations of that company. After World War II, Olympio became prominent in efforts for independence of Togo, and his party won the 1958 elections, making him the prime minister of the country. His power was further cemented when Togo achieved independence and he won the 1961 election, making him the first ever president of Togo. He was assassinated during the 1963 Togolese coup d'etat. Number 17, Thomas Sankara, 1987, head of state of Burkina Faso. Thomas Isidore Noël Sankara was a Burkinabe militant socialist justice campaigner and president of Burkina Faso from 1983 to 1987. A Marxist-Leninist and Pan-Africanist, he was viewed by supporters as a charismatic and iconic figure of revolution, and is sometimes referred to as Africa's Che Guevara. After being appointed prime minister in 1983, disputes with the sitting government led to Sankara's eventual imprisonment. While he was under house arrest, a group of revolutionaries seized power on his behalf in a popular-supported coup later that year. Aged 33, Sankara became the president of the Republic of Upper Volta. He immediately launched programs for social, ecological, and economic change and renamed the country from the French colonial name Upper Volta to Burkina Faso, land of incorruptible people. With his people being called Burkinabe, upright people, his foreign policies were centered on an anti-imperialism, with his government eschewing all foreign aid, pushing for odious debt reduction, nationalizing all land and mineral wealth, and averting the power and influence of the International Monetary Fund and World Bank. On the 15th October 1987, Sankara was killed by an armed group with 12 other officials in a coup d'etat organized by his former colleague Blaise Compaoré. When accounting for his overthrow, Compaoré stated that Sankara jeopardized foreign relations with former colonial powers, France and neighboring Ivory Coast, and accused his former comrade of plotting to assassinate opponents. Number 18, Muhammad Anwar al-Sadat, 1981, President of Egypt. Muhammad Anwar al-Sadat was an Egyptian politician who served as the third president of Egypt from 15th October 1970 until his assassination by fundamentalist army officers on 6th October 1981. Sadat was a senior member of the Free Officers who overthrew King Farouk in the Egyptian Revolution in 1952 and a close confidant of President Gamal Abdel Nasser, under whom he served as vice president twice and whom he succeeded as president in 1970. In 1978, Sadat and Menachem Begin, Prime Minister of Israel, signed a peace treaty in cooperation with United States President Jimmy Carter, for which they were recognized with the Nobel Peace Prize. On the 6th of October 1981, Sadat was assassinated during the annual victory parade held in Cairo to celebrate Egypt's crossing of the Suez Canal. Inslamboli emptied his assault rifle into Sadat's body while in the front of the grandstand, mortally wounding the president. In addition to Sadat, 11 others were killed, including the Cuban ambassador, an Omani general, a Coptic Orthodox bishop, and Sami Helmi, the head of Egypt's Central Auditing Agency, CAA. 28 were wounded, including Vice President Hosni Mubarak, Irish Defense Minister James Dooley, and 4 US military liaison officers. The assassination squad was led by Lieutenant Khalid Inzambudi after a fatwa approving the assassination had been obtained from Omar Abdel Rahman. Inzambudi was tried, found guilty, sentenced to death, and executed by firing squad in April 1982. Number 19, Murtala Mohammed, 1976. General Murtala Mohammed was a Nigerian Army general who was the fourth head of state of Nigeria from 1975 until his assassination in 1976. Murtala Mohammed was killed aged 37, along with his aide-de-camp, ADC, Lieutenant Akinkunde Akindeshiwa, in an abortive coup attempt led by Lieutenant Colonel Buka Suka Dimka when his car was ambushed en route to his office at Dodan Barracks, Lagos, by a group of soldiers. During his brief stint as Nigeria's leader, he acquired a reputation as a leader who traveled about without the fanfare typically associated with leaders in Nigeria. He hardly traveled in a convoy of attached vehicles. He was not known to blare sirens whenever he traveled in his car. He often travels incognito. The only visible sign of protection was a pistol carried by his orderly, therefore making his assassination an easy task. Number 20, Abdirashid Ali Shemak, 1969, President of Somalia. Abdirashid Ali Shemak, also known as Abdirashid Shemak, was Prime Minister of Somalia Republic from July 12, 1960 to June 14, 1964, and President of Somalia Republic from July 6, 1967 until his assassination on October 15, 1969. He was the father of Somali Prime Minister Omar Abdirashid Ali Shemak. In 1968, Shemak narrowly escaped an assassination attempt. A grenade exploded near the car that was transporting him back from the airport but failed to kill him. On October 15, 1969, while paying an official visit to the northern town of Las Anot, Shemak was shot dead by one of his own bodyguards. On duty outside the guest house where the president was staying, the officer fired an automatic rifle at close range, instantly killing Shemak. Observers suggested that the assassination was inspired by personal rather than political motives. Shamak's assassination was quickly followed by a military coup d'etat on October 21, 1969, the day after his funeral, in which the Somali army seized power without encountering armed opposition, essentially a bloodless takeover. The putsch was spearheaded by Major General Muhammad Ziad Barre, who at the time commanded the army. Thanks for watching this video. If you did enjoy this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and do not forget to subscribe and share with your friends.